The League for People with Disabilities has been making a difference in the lives of not only the disabled, but their families for almost 90 years. I have featured this nonprofit before on Maryland Perspectives, and because they give such a lifeline and bring people out of isolation, I am happy to welcome David Greenburg, the CEO, back to the program. Good morning, David.
Good morning, Amelia.
Now, let's get right into it. What kind of disabilities are you helping people with?
We accommodate people with all kinds of disabilities, whether it's a developmental disability, something that you acquired at birth or sometime while you were developing, or something that occurred after age 21, and like a spinal cord injury or a stroke or maybe a head injury. We do all those disabilities.
Can you tell me about some of the unique programs that the League offers to individuals with disabilities?
Besides medical daycare, which many people do, we have specific programs for people who've had a stroke and have difficulty speaking or have multiple sclerosis. We have an MS Day program where people with the same affliction can discuss how they're accommodating things. The League overall, it helps people live well with whatever disability that they have. Another unique program of the League, Camp Greentop. Way back in 1937, we began working with what became the National Park Service, and we have this wonderful camp for children and adults with disabilities up in the Catoctin Mountains north of Frederick. And that's very unique, and many people with disabilities across the state come to that program.
So besides the programs, you're also helping people out in their homes, too. You offer home care, if I remember correctly?
We offer personal supports, which is a little different than the traditional health care, home care. We take people who've got disabilities and are funded through the state, will go into their homes, provide services if they have a child with autism, or perhaps they have anybody who's getting developmental disabilities funding, and we can go into the home and provide services, or better yet, go into the home, bring the individual, whether it's a child or adult, out and help them to explore the community. That's called personal supports. And that's relatively new, and there is state funding for that. Maryland is a great state in that it does take care of people with disabilities, and the state understands the importance of funding programs like that so that the families can continue to have their loved one with them and aren't such a burden to the whole family system.
Right. And you're also, once you get them out of the house, you're giving families their own free time so that it's not 24-hour around the clock. And I think one of the things that I'm most impressed by your nonprofit is the fact that you're giving the independence that these people with disabilities are craving. It changes their lives. So how do you assist with this?
I want to point one more thing out when you're talking about giving the families a break. Yes,
sure.
It certainly does that. But think about this. I know when I was growing up, I so much wanted to get out of the house and get away from my traditional caregivers. So you get to go out with a pretty cool person, a direct support professional that we would provide. So that's just another way to look at it. The individuals, the support counselors that go into someone's home or provide services here, they're called direct support professionals for a reason. They're supporting that individual in whatever way is good for that individual to become more independent, self-sufficient, and have a good quality of life. So we're not just opening a door for a person. Perhaps that person needs to open the door themselves because we may not always be there, and we want them to learn that skill. We're helping people become independent any way that works for that individual. Some people require everything done for them. Right. Other people just require that support, that little push, that little reminder of what they need to do to be a better functioning human being,
right,
individual in society.
A big part of that is finding employment, and you are also sourcing out jobs to folks that you're helping out. Tell us about those programs.
We'll work with someone and find out what are their skills. Everybody has some particular skill, even if it's a giant smile. We'll help them to get the right job. We don't have contracts with Some of the other agencies will have a contract for doing housekeeping or doing laundry or doing landscaping, that sort of thing. If someone wants to do that, we will find a place for them to do that. We don't just place them just to fill our contracts. We will find a employer that best fits. And we also will go into the employers and see what are their needs and what are they looking for and what's going to benefit them. There's a young man that we placed in a bar down in Federal Hill, and he has been there for years, and he is a stable force there. I think he cleans the floors, wipes down tables, probably does dishes. And when people go into that bar, they see him, they know him, he's got the big smile,
right.
And he wants to do that day in and day out. And to an employer, having someone reliable day in and day out to be there and to be a great customer service person,
right,
where everybody feels good when they see him and know his name and smile at him. That's what we do. We find that right niche for an individual because I think all of us, and especially your listeners, if you think about your job, it's not just a job to make money and put food on the table and clothing. It's a job. A job gives you a sense of being, a sense of purpose in life. You do job a lot more than you do recreational. And so having a job is very important to your mental health. And individuals who want to work and just can't get a job, that's a sad thing. And so we try to make sure that we get people placed in the job that's going to be meaningful to them and it's going to be helping out the employers.
And let's get into those social activities. We've talked about the club before that you have, which just is, always sounds amazing to me.
Just to get Club 1111 out of the way, the second Saturday every month, we have 500-600 people from various places all around Maryland, mostly people with disabilities, but anybody is welcome. It's an inclusive nightclub that caters to people with disabilities, so we have wider hallways, we have various places you can go if you get a little bit too overstimulated. It's a lot of fun and a lot of people making those social connections because we find that is probably the most fun and most important for some people thing that they come to the league for, to engage. People with significant disabilities, many of them can take care of themselves. They can be home, but they can't drive themselves. They don't have great mobility. So they're pretty much kind of stuck where they are. If they get a ride somewhere, they want to be somewhere where there's other people they can engage with. So we do that, whether it's going out into the community with other people through our Dayhab program or other employment programs, whether it's coming here and being part of the after-school program that we have, or you're coming into medical day. People come for the social aspects, but also to learn new skills. We're all about fun.
And everybody wants a little bit of fun, which brings me to your annual fundraiser. I can't believe a year has passed already, and it's the OMG Food Event. Tell us the details on this and how it helps out the league for people with disabilities.
Well, this is our major fundraiser, and we try to raise at least $100,000 to help all these programs that don't cover their costs. This will be the third year. We're back at La Cuchara. Ben Leffenfeld, the executive chef there, will have some enticing entrees for people. This year, Jerry Trice from Gunther & Company, and these are the executive chefs. He'll be there. Julian Marucci from Taglia will be there. Steve Chu from Ichaban. Great food. It's amazing. Every year it gets better and better. But there's live music. I think it's Speakers of the House are playing. There's an amazing silent auction. Who knows what'll be there. I think it was last year or the year before they had seats from the old Memorial Stadium that were at the silent auction. I love that. All kinds of craft beer, signature cocktails. A lot of fun. I think there's a food truck out front. You know, if there's not enough food inside, there's a food truck out front. That La Cuchara, it's an amazing, amazing place, but I think tickets are $125. They could be $150, but it's on our website, leagueforpeople.org. They'll have to suffer through a great night on October 3rd from 6 to 10 p.m.
And that website, is that also where people will go for more information about your services,
yep,
or even to volunteer?
for everything. Yes, we didn't talk about it, but we even have a gym and a pool. It's called the League's Wellness Center, open to the community. A lot of people come here. Their kids learn to swim here. Saturday afternoons, we have swim lessons. All of that information is at leagueforpeople.org.
David Greenburg is the CEO of the League for People with Disabilities. David, I'll make sure I get those links up on our website, 98online.com. And it's always great to catch up with you and the good things you're doing for the people in Maryland. Thanks for checking in.
All right. Thank you, Amelia.